Well, we are here with Veronica Vega. She is the assistant brewmaster here at Deschutes, and you also head up
the operations at the Bend Pub.
All right. And
it's busy.
You're going to talk about a question that we've wondered about, mm-hmm. and that is, what's so special about Central Oregon water?
Well, I mean, all you have to do is open the tap and take a glass of water or leave the area and try to drink other people's tap water. And then you're rushing home to get that cold, beautiful glass of water. So everyone who lives in Bend knows that we have amazing water. You go hiking in our watershed and you see that mm-hmm. you're getting water from a very pristine and beautiful place. And we luck out as brewers here to not have to do much to treat the water to make great beer. Where we do put effort is the conservation of the water, so that's why we donated 1 billion gallons of water back to the Deschutes River, our namesake. So
without getting, and you have a biology background, without being too deep in the weeds, scientific mm-hmm. weeds, what does make the water special, or do we know? I mean, is it, or
does it just taste good, or is there something more to it?
Obviously, flavor is the easiest thing to
point to.
Tip you off, to good quality water. Mm-hmm. But it is the ionic components of the water, and we have really soft water here in Bend, so that's great for making pilsners. But we make ale, so we harden the water by adding calcium sulfate.
What do you love about your job here? Because I know you said you started in tours, so then you kind of just made your way over to a much bigger role.
Yeah. People say all the time, you have my dream job, or you must have like the best job in the world, and it is pretty awesome to be down here and experimenting for a large brewery, but kind of heading that R&D side of things and using our fans here in Bend as kind of the testing ground for new recipes and new styles.
How often are you wrong, meaning you think you've got a winner, and then you put out the taste test and people go,
With some projects, there are more challenging ones. For example, one of the Bend Pub's biggest project has been gluten-free beer. Now, there's not a lot of people that make gluten-free beer. There's not a lot of history of that. So this was really like, okay, we're charging ground here. So we've made a lot of mistakes, but with all those mistakes, we've learned. And here at the pub right now, I think we're on our 65th batch, test batch of gluten-free beer, and it's our best one yet. So we keep learning and moving forward.
Wow. So I always wonder with people like you and your job, how far back does your love of science and kind of, like John said, tinkering with things and trying to get things right go back? I mean, do you remember like eighth grade science just fascinated by it?
I remember like, this sounds terrible, but like dissecting a frog, not like in science class, but like in my backyard, which makes me sound like kind of a morbid child. But I think curiosity has always been, huge for me. And also the artistic side of things, there's just a lot of expression in making something for, the population to enjoy and trying new things and saying, hey, you probably don't think you like this, but, you might, so.
Hmm. Now, it's just the three of us talking here, okay? A lot of brewmasters from Deschutes have gone off and started their own thing.
Right.
You want to make any announcements today?
No. I feel so blessed to work for a company where I can do experimentation and still, be a part of a national presence. And when we travel as brewers, we just get, fans that are just insane about our beer. And we come back to Bend just so refreshed and excited about what we do. So. Also, I come from a family where, my dad owns his own business, so I know how that goes.
How tough it is.
What is the hard? I mean, everybody says, "Oh, Bronnie, you got the dream job." What's the hardest part of your job? Because I'm sure there's a lot of hard work.
Not being able to just leave it. I mean, I am like at night not able to sleep sometimes because I am thinking of ideas because they just come at random times. Or did I do that? Did I not do that? Should I do this? Should I do that? It's just constant in my head.
And are the ideas about new flavors, new approaches to beer, or how can I make this one established beer better?
Yeah, it's definitely ideas, new ideas. I mean, there's so many breweries just in Bend. There's so many breweries, you know, in the world. To try to find something that no one has done is almost impossible. You're always trying to find something like that, but it's also process driven. Like, you know, how can I make this process better? How could I work a little smarter and not harder, because it is hard work. So, you know, did I leave that valve open?
Yeah,
at work, so that type of stuff.
That's about at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Exactly.
Wake up. Is there someone you look up to as a brewer in town? Someone that you can, that people might know their name, where you're like, you know, they've done really great things, and you aspire to be like them?
Well, I mean, I worked under Larry Sador. He was our brewmaster. And he's come from very large operations and now owns his own brew pub, living out his dream, and nowhere near retiring. So I do aspire for a very, very long career and a presence in our industry.
Well, what's your favorite beer? We have to ask you that.
Oh, geez. Yeah. Even knowing that you would probably ask this question, I hope you guys realize that this is the hardest question for us.
Of course.
Especially someone
who
makes beer.
We told you we were going to ask you the hard, investigative questions.
Especially, I mean, I feel like I'm a pretty moody person when it comes to, you know, like,
which
what
beer
do
you're
I
drinking
want
one.
Right
Come
now.
On.
But I love our Dissident because I love sour beers. But you could pretty much hand me a pail at any time, you know, any situation, I will enjoy it greatly. So
maybe 3 o'clock in the morning when you wake up with this freaked out notion about the valve being open. Just take a little sip. Okay, better.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for being with us and sharing a little bit about yourself.
Of course.
Now people know who's behind the beers.
And they can probably approach you anytime.
Oh, I have a window that people can just knock and wave right here at the pub. So
we'll be doing it.
Stand outside with posters like, we
exactly.
love Veronica.
I might shoot you with a hose.
Well, thanks
well, thank
again.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Take care.